We consume an increasing amount of minerals in everyday life, but mineral resources are not inexhaustible. When we extract metals from underground deposits, many are left behind, as the remaining elements are not valuable enough to extract. This is known as mineral processing waste. To extract valuable metals from mineral processing waste, scientists began to study a natural phenomenon, bioleaching. Let's see how it works. Mineral processing waste contains minerals, but also living bacteria.
We bacteria can thrive in these piles of waste. All we need is access to air and water to multiply. But we also need energy, which we can collect by dissolving and transforming metals. This is bioleaching. In the process, we release acids that can pollute soils and cause environmental damage. To scale this process up for our needs, the scientists came up with a process to boost our metal production. To do this, the mineral matter we live in is ground into a powder and plunged into a bioreactor, a large and continuously stirred tank with water and nutrients. In this environment, we can thrive and multiply exponentially. The result is a solution that contains the metals originally contained in the mining waste. Then, all that's left to do is chemically filter the solution to retrieve the metals in solid form. This process also has the benefit of keeping the sulfuric acid we produce within the lab or factory. Otherwise, it may leach into the soil. The bioleaching process has moved beyond research and is now applied in the field. Bioleaching produces 5% of all gold and 20 to 25% of all copper extracted today. And research is still underway to find methods of applying this process to other waste, such as circuit boards, for example. In this manner, scientists have found new methods that protect the environment and reduce waste by extracting the most value from it.